So, today we're going to dive into a really fascinating economic scenario. We're asking, what happens when a big problem erupts from inside the financial system itself? We'll see how a central bank can step in and kind of play the hero, and how a situation that sounds pretty scary might just have a surprisingly simple fix. Okay, imagine this. For whatever reason, a wave of uncertainty hits, and people all across the country start losing a little faith in the banks. They decide to rush out and withdraw their money. Now, they're not going on a spending spree, they just want to hold on to the physical cash. Seems like a simple enough action, right? But what does that actually do to the entire economy? Well, in the world of economics, this has a specific name. It's called a negative internal shock. The key word there is internal. It means the problem started right there inside the money market. It wasn't caused by some big event from the outside world. And here's the crucial part. When all that cash leaves the banking system, the total amount of money circulating in the economy actually shrinks. And that shrinkage, it's a huge deal. It's not just some minor blip. It sets off this powerful chain reaction, kind of like watching a whole line of economic dominoes start to fall, one right after the other. And each one that tips over pushes the economy into a more and more dangerous spot. So let's trace out exactly how that chain reaction works. It all starts with step one. People pull their cash out of the banks. Now, because of that, as you see in step two, the money supply gets smaller. When money is scarcer, it becomes more expensive to borrow, which means overall spending in the economy, what economists call aggregate demand, goes down. And that's the third domino. So what's the final one to fall? Well, with less spending, businesses have to cut back, and that means people lose their jobs. The economy slips into a state of unemployment. And just like that, something as simple as people wanting to hold physical cash has spiraled into a real problem. Fewer jobs and a shrinking economy. It's a classic downward spiral. So that leaves us with the million-dollar question. Is there any way to stop this thing? Can we fix it? Oh, absolutely. This is where the central bank gets to step onto the scene. You see, for this very specific kind of internal shock, it has an incredibly powerful and, honestly, an elegant tool that's perfect for the job. And the answer is a policy called monetary expansion. The logic here is actually beautiful in its simplicity. If the core problem is that the money supply is shrinking, well, the central bank's job is to do the exact opposite, to actively expand it. It's basically fighting fire with water. Now check this out, because what's so cool here is how this is a perfect mirror image of the problem. First, the central bank pumps more money into the system. That makes money less scarce, so it gets cheaper to borrow. Interest rates fall. With those lower rates, businesses and regular people feel more confident about spending and investing, which pushes aggregate demand back up, shifting it to the right. And the final beautiful result? The economy gets put right back on its feet, returning to full employment. And this really illustrates the main takeaway perfectly. When the shock comes from inside the money market, monetary policy can be like a surgeon's scalpel. The central bank can step in and perfectly counteract the initial problem. It can neutralize it completely. Now, I know what you might be thinking. This sounds almost too easy, right? And you know what? You're right to be a little skeptical. It turns out this is what economists would consider a relatively easy problem to solve. And that's because, and this is so important, not all economic shocks are created equal. So let's just compare for a second. On the one hand, you have an internal shock, like that run on the banks we just talked about. There's a clean, direct fix. But on the other hand, you have an external shock. Think about something like a global supply chain crisis or a sudden war that makes oil prices skyrocket. That is a whole different ballgame. For that kind of problem, the central bank faces a really painful trade-off. This really gets to the heart of the matter. The origin of the problem, where it comes from, determines everything. There's a great saying that sums it up. When the shock is internal, it's very easy for the central bank to handle. The real difficulty, the real headache, comes when that shock is external. That's when you get into these impossible situations. And here is that impossible situation. An external shock often creates two massive problems at the exact same time. You get rising prices, or inflation, and you get rising unemployment. The trouble is, the central bank has tools to fight one, or it has tools to fight the other, but it can't fix both at once. It's forced into a corner where it has to choose which problem is the lesser of two evils. So we end on a much tougher question, a real dilemma. When the problem comes from the outside world and you can only save one thing, what do you choose? Do you try to save jobs, even if it means letting prices spiral out of control? Or do you clamp down on prices and protect people's savings, even if it costs people their jobs? That's the brutal trade-off that makes this stuff so incredibly difficult in the real world.